sort of like that. That's another option, the shad pole. You make sure you got more of those B&Ms in the boat. You have those 5-footers, ultralights, 6-footers, the 7.6s for throwing floats and everything else. But boy, look at that good hook. You better have that 10, 11, and 12 footers. My favorite, the Sam's Super Sensitive, because that's what's in there, right there. Let's let them go. But you come up to a spot like this, throwing a cork, catching 2, 3, maybe 10, 15 fish, but you know, when you look and see how deep and dark that is, those big ones, they get big for a reason. You know why? Because they're somewhat smart. Not too smart, don't give them too much credit. But a little bit of pressure, you're catching a few fish, you're missing a few, they might pull right into the real heavy, nasty, messy stuff. The 10, 11, and 12 footers, you just take out your line, just like that. So now, I got 12 feet in the pole, then I got about 10, 11 feet in the line, so that's almost 20 feet that I can stay back like this, position, come up slow, and just find my little spot and put the bait in, little hole, and just shake it like that. Oh boy, that's a good one. That's a good one. Oh, look where he's caught up on the stuff. Uh-oh. How are we gonna get this one up? Oh, I lift him over the top. Lift him over the back. And a crappie in the boat. Holy God, man. You cannot tell me that's not a blast. Again, perfect eating size fish, man. Anywhere that, oh, I love the taste of crappie. But you know what? I'm looking for your grandpapa, grandmama. So you, luckily, can go back. But you know, if you love bass fishing or walleye fishing, you live for that tick. And that's either throwing that big flipping jig by a dock or ripping a little grub or a little hair jig on a weed line for walleye. That bait's falling and all you feel is that magical tick. There's only one thing it can be, fish. And in this case, they're just honkered right inside this tree and that little shad pole inside there. As soon as it goes down, I lift, I'm not even shaking a lot because that little tail, as you can see, that little ball moves enough. Sometimes the least amount of action is the best. Putting it down a little bit, hold it, or all of a sudden there's a weight sensation and crappie on. Ooh, nice crappie, nice crappie. Look at that thing fight. Look at that, right in the nose too. Whoa, that's a good one right there, boy. That's a good one right there. That's another eater. That's what I call an eater right there. Look at that big, beautiful slab, boy. Oh yeah, look at that. Gorgeous crappie right there. Nice thick backs on them. Look at that. Tell me you wouldn't want 10 of those, 12 of those, make for a good meal. Let's put them inside here. Shad poling and the long 12'2" Sam Super Sensitive. It's just like you can just do the best of both worlds. Search and destroy with the float. Then when you find the fish, catch a few, exhaust them, pressure them, whatever you want to call it. Get into the nasty stuff. You're going to catch them with the Mr. Crappie Shad Pole by Strike King.
B&M Sam Super Sensitive Jig Pole. Featuring a two-piece light jigging rod, cork handle feels light bites. Made of IM6 graphite with aluminum oxide guides. Available in 9, 10, 11, and 12-foot models. Retails for $76 US. Visit bnmpoles.com.
When it comes to crappie, everyone has their favorite colors. But I like anything like the electric chicken with pink, chartreuse. And this water is fairly clear. I could actually see some of those bites in the trees, but it doesn't matter. When you're right on those fish and they're congregated and they're really holding to a little spot like that, something that attracts their attention will eat it. So the pink chartreuse, you know, black with a little bit of purple. Then I have that, like that purple haze. It has the purple with the chartreuse. Awesome little bait. Chartreuse white, I think it's called refrigerator white. And you got the natural tones like the blue silvers, natural salt and pepper. And of course, like the blue glitter, almost looks like a real minnow killer. Buy the ones you're comfortable with. So I would suggest you buy a lot. Oh boy, that one is big. And look at where he's caught around. He is around the tree. Oh Lordy, let him swim a bit. Oh no, look at him. That is a big, big crappie. Look at him, caught up around the tree, over the tree. Get around the tree. Oh, is he coming in the boat? Look where he got it too. Tell me he didn't want that thing. When that little shad pole's in the right spot, and that is inside that tree, they just bulldoze their way to find it and eat it. Again, another fine eater. You know what? Just not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the big, fat slabs. But that's a good eater right there. Beautiful Ontario crappie. Didn't take too long. Crappie come up the other side of the tree. It's unbelievable when you watch that little bait and all of a sudden it just disappears. And the crappie just inhales it. And that's about dissecting the tree. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna put him over on this side so he doesn't go back and maybe tell some of his buddies not to bite my jig. Go on. So sometimes when you're fishing a tree, bush, brush pile, it doesn't matter what it is, you get something as visible as this, you know it's holding fish. Caught him on the cork out there, then picked up the big long pole, single pulled it, come around. Put the power poles down, find your spots, little holes, and start dissecting it once again.